Good morning, Huntington North. I'm Eli Pence.
And I'm Lillian Schottman, and this is HNHS Today for Wednesday, November 13th.
The Huntington North Robotics Team, Team 1501, will be holding a call-out meeting tomorrow at the Learning Center from 6 to 7 p.m.
The robotics team has room for everyone, from engineering and design to business and fundraising. The team is ranked first in the state, and we're looking forward to welcoming new members for the upcoming season.
Monday was Veterans Day, and it becomes a tradition at HNHS to hold a convocation to the spotlight veterans and what their service means to us.
Sydney was able to get footage of Monday's event. Let's take a look.
There are several veterans that I would like to honor today. I would like to honor those that are currently serving, have served, or are getting ready to serve in our military. I would also like to thank the guests that have showed up today to help make this event very successful. For those that have passed, my heart goes out to you and your families. You will never be forgotten. Thank you.
I would like to honor some of my family members who served. I had a great uncle that served during the Korean War. And he was taken as a prisoner of war and died in captivity. And then my other great uncle was in World War II, and he was killed in Italy and is buried in Italy in an American cemetery in Italy. So, but I have a lot of other relatives that have served as well, and I'm trying to honor them by my service.
And I would like to honor my uncle who served in the military. And my grandpa served in the Marines.
The veterans I'd like to thank are all the ones that I served with. So I served with a bunch of them in Bosnia in 2002, all my guys I served with in the invasion in Iraq in 2003, all the Delta Company 293rd guys, and then all the guys that I went back to Iraq with in 2008. So all my brothers and sisters that I served with my 26 years, you guys are my heroes. I love you all. And if you need anything, reach out to me. God bless.
Thank you, Sydney. If you didn't do so on Monday, take a moment to thank a veteran.
If you're a student who regularly checks your Canvas Class Of page, you may have noticed a link to an optional PSAT score report session.
That session took place yesterday, but we went to Mr. Hamill for more information.
I'll just briefly touch on the purpose of the PSAT. This is a test that the state requires us to offer all sophomores, and we push all our sophomores to take it. It is a college-based readiness type test. It's in the College Board series. It's the first of the series that most people take. The P a lot of times is taken as practice for the real SAT. So it's not what colleges ask for, but it'll help give you an idea of where you're at. And certainly as sophomores, you need to start thinking about your future college or career trajectory. So in this building, about 30 to 35% of our students will go on to college. We realize this isn't for everybody. This can help solidify that decision that you're going to make as you enter your junior and senior years. I think it's important to have that in mind. This is not a test that you have to pass to graduate. It's truly meant for you to feel out what is the best path for you moving forward. And then everyone as a junior in the building does have to take the SAT. That's a little more serious. The scores do matter if you're college bound. They don't necessarily matter if you're not. But you never know what your future path will hold. You may, as I remember where I was at, 14, 15-year-old, I often thought I was going to be a conservation officer. Looking back, that's funny to me now because I don't think that was in my skill set. But what I'm saying is you don't want to put yourself in a box necessarily. Your career path may take a little different turn. So I would tell you to always do as best as you can on these tests. So you're asking about the score report session. We are offering that to students. Next week, if you have trouble accessing your College Board account, it's not something that you access very frequently, especially if you're a sophomore and you're just getting into this and you don't even remember how to get in. I would be happy to get you in if you're interested. I can also just email you a PDF of your score report. We've put a platform, something out on Parent Square where parents can request that. We'll send them a PDF of the score report. But we can do it a couple different ways. We can just send you the score report. We can get you into the platform. The College Board platform is more in-depth. It'll tell you your areas of weakness. It'll tell you much more than the PDF. And you can also link it to Khan Academy where you can get extra practice. So if you're a highly motivated student, you're definitely going, I'm headed to college, I want to get as high a score and as many scholarship dollars as I can, you can start the practice of preparing for the SAT now that you've taken this PSAT. It'll tailor resources to your needs and your deficiencies. So again, this is a thing that does not impact our whole student body. It's not a bad thing if you're not going to college, but we want to serve those who are as best we can, because we want you to have the best opportunity to get into some of these universities and also get as much money as you can. So that's why we're offering this opportunity to get into your College Board account, access your scores. You can sign up for that on your Class Canvas page.
High Hopes Huntington North Suicide Prevention Group meets every Tuesday during Study Hall in room 203. All previous members of Sources of Strength and all students interested in the mental health of students are welcome to attend.
Walkaway meets every Tuesday after school in the Locker Lounge. Walkaway is a walking group that welcomes all students to be more physically and mentally healthy by making a habit of walking daily. Any student is welcome to join.
Tomorrow is the deadline to sign up for the Salvation Army Co-Ed Basketball. Any HN student can sign up at the Salvation Army.
Speaking of basketball, let's go to Ben and Cohen for sports.
Thanks, guys. For the first time ever on HNHS Today, we can say the football team is sectional champion. The Vikings defeated Lebanon Friday 31-28 in overtime.
Tony Decker led the Vikings offense with 241 total yards, including 159 through the air. Marcus Linker led the ground attack with 90 yards. Jimmy Linker finished with 129 receiving yards, including the game-tying 54-yard touchdown reception to force overtime.
Johan von Chandersleven nailed the game-winning 32-yard field goal to secure the Vikings' first sectional title since 1993.
We caught up with some of the players to talk about the historic victory.
Hey Vikes, as many of you know, our Huntington North football team won a sectional this past weekend. Today, I'm going to be asking some of the football players that are part of this team what this win felt like and what we can expect from the future.
In the beginning, we struggled a little bit. We went down 14-0 in the first half, and we were able to come back from that and make the game tied at halftime. And then coming back from halftime, we scored on our first drive, and that gave us some momentum for the rest of the game. And then as the game went on, fourth quarter was really tough. We just had to grind it out. And then at the end of the game, end of the fourth quarter, we went for a field goal, and it got blocked. And in overtime, our defense stood well, and then we made a field goal to win the game. This week, we're just going to really focus on getting better every day, not letting this win just define us, and hopefully get this win on Friday.
Just throughout the entire game, we just kept battling through the entire game. The score kept going back and forth, but we just had that fight in us, and we had that resilience through the entire game. We just need to have a better week at practice. We had a couple of rough days early in the week, but towards the end of the week had a better practice. But if we continue that consistency throughout the entire week, we can be the most prepared we can be.
Our win this week was the best it could have ever been. We really battled between each quarter, and like we were fighting for first downs. We were fighting to get the Lebanon off the field, and we just came through in the end with the win. And I'm just proud of all of our guys. We kept fighting no matter what, and we always kept our heads high. To prepare for next week against East Noble, we need to have a better practice. Monday and Tuesday's practice was not very good. We need to be more focused and be dialed in and to win against East Noble.
It sounds like the Vikes fought really hard to get this win this past weekend against Lebanon. And it looks like we're going to have some pretty good practices this week to look forward up to this East Noble game. Let's get back to the studio.
The Vikings will travel to East Noble Friday for the regional. Kickoff is set for 7 p.m.
The girls basketball team opened its season last night, hosting Fort Wayne Snyder. We'll have those results next week.
The Lady Vikings will travel to Warsaw Saturday. The junior varsity game will tip off at 6 p.m. with the varsity game to follow.
That's all we have for this week. Let's go back to the desk.
Thanks, guys. Remember, Vikes, tomorrow is a special study hall symposium for students who requested and received a ticket. you should have received your ticket earlier this week.
Have a great week, Vikings, and you'll see us next week.
It's fine. It's cool.